Hi, I'm Terrell Sorensen. We're going to go out today and look at some irrigation wells. What we want to do is take and show you how to measure the water level in your wells.
Getting well measurements over time is important to you as an irrigator or homeowner so you can react in a timely manner. Having a well log like the one shown here is a valuable tool. It shows you the original water levels to compare to your current measurements. If you don't have one, then your first measurements will establish your static water level. This spot right here indicates the static water level when the well was dug. The static water level is the level where the water sits when the pump is off. When the pump is on, the water level drops to the pumping level shown here. The first thing we must do is find the well casing. This is a closed well casing. That means the pump is already installed and everything is set up ready to pump. The best case scenario is that your well has an airline installed which can be used to measure the water depth. You will need a small air tank like this one. Attach it to the airline and add pressure to the line. The gauge will quickly go up. Once it stops moving, then release the pressure. Pressure will go down and stop again at a lower level. Repeat this process two more times to purge the airline. Note the pressure of the lower point and use the following equation to calculate your well depth measurement. If you don't have an airline, you can measure the well using a tool called a well sounder. Basically, this is a long measuring tape with a sensor in it that will alert you when you've reached the water. To get your measurement, you will need to find a small opening in the casing and insert the tip through the hole. Make sure the sounder is on and lower it down the well. Once you hear the sound, you will get your depth measurement. Roll the cable up a foot or two, then re-lower to make sure your measurements are consistent. If you have a new open well and need to find the static water level, another option is using a long tape measure like this one and then attaching a half-filled water bottle or float to the end of it. Lower the float and feel the tension on the tape once you hit the water. You might find online methods for calculating depth like throwing a rock in the well and timing it until it hits the water. These types of methods are not recommended and not highly accurate. It is important to keep good records of your well depths, including static water level and pumping level. The best times to check depths is during the pumping season. In particular, it's good to get measurements quarterly, late March, midsummer, and late fall. If you are finding your well depth is going down over time, then maybe you need to talk to the Idaho Department of Water Resources.